Firstly, I want to start off by asking you about your family and your upbringing. Where does your family come from?
Well, I was raised in American Samoa and lived in the Pangupangu village. And so, but you know, in those days we had a simple upbringing. We didn't have any paved roads and we didn't have a school bus. The harbor was dotted with outhouses and everything. But that is the American Samoa I grew up in.
Simple life, but a happy life.
Yes.
So that brings us to now, how you got into politics. Where did that start for you?
Well, actually, my background is in psychology. I never really thought about getting into politics. I think it just evolved. But I do come from a family with kind of a legacy of public service. And my auntie, Mabel Reed, she was the first woman ever to be elected to the whono, the legislative, the House side in American Samoa. I'm kind of a Pacific brat, lived in the Marshall Islands, where my father governed the Marshall Islands. He was the governor of American Samoa for 16 years. And so we never really noticed, but for me, that kind of became the norm, being in the public eye like that, because they will focus not only on that leader, but his wife, the children, and everything else, you know. I should say that about a month ago, one of my brothers was going through some of my father's things, and there was a letter in there. It was three pages, handwritten by my father, back in 1994, where he was trying to tell people that I should run for Congress, and this is why. He thought, wow, I could do the job. But when he and I talked about it, I said, Dad, you know, I think I'd like to run for Congress. And he says, well, I tell you what, okay, you run, but you're a woman. You might as well understand that this is Samoa. Mm-hmm. You're a woman. And the men are perceived to be the ones with all the brains. But he said, you know, it's going to take you probably 20 years. Mm. And sure enough, it took me 22 years of running and losing.
That's right.
Constantly, you know. Mm. And it was kind of a character building thing. That is my message, not only to the strong women here of Pasifika, but really to the young women in the region and everywhere, that's part of the reason that I ran, to provide the shoulders for them to stand on. Because you have to pry that door. There has to be a first time to pry that door open. But the person who pries the door open may not be the one.
Right.
Who walks through the door.
That you are the first woman elected to the U.S. House of Representatives from American Samoa. So tell me how you balance your American Samoan culture with politics.
It's not that difficult. I'm very involved in the Samoa. I'm very Osi'ainga, Kausingu'u, Ekalesia, and all of that. I like everybody to know that I'm a Samoan, and so what you see me wearing, this is what I wear on the U.S. House floor. There are 441 of us, and I'm the only one who looks different, and everybody knows. They may not know my name, but they know that flower and that pulutasi.
Tell me about American Samoa and what some of the key issues you're facing at the moment.
Economic development is at the top, because economic development is the engine that fuels everything else. It creates jobs for the people, and when the people have jobs, you know, they're happy, and the other things flow from that.
Is it sometimes hard to get the ear of the U.S. government in helping solve the issues in American Samoa?
You would think it were, but it hasn't been. You know, so the president has been in office for 13 months, and in all that time, I guess I've been with the president 9 times, and the White House is very accessible to us.
You agree with his policies and the way his administration is run?
I do agree with a lot of the things he does. Now, I can't apologize for the fact that he grew up in Queens, where they're belligerent and pugnacious. He's a New Yorker, you know? But I think he's doing tremendous things for the United States, and it's going to pick itself up. I mean, Just in those 13 months, 3 million jobs have been created, and this tax cut thing, it's only now beginning to blossom, to see the results. And I'm very optimistic that American Samoa will be benefiting. We already are, in a big way.
Do they know anything in the way of Pasifika culture, our values, beliefs? Have you had those discussions with them?
Well, I've had a chance to talk with Ivanka, his daughter. As a matter of fact, she did send me a note after Cyclone Gita hit us hard in American Samoa. And yes, the Trump administration is very attentive to the Pacific Islanders and Native Americans, you know.
American Samoa exists next to, you know, the sovereign state of Samoa. Could you see a time when American Samoa becomes independent?
I often get the question, when are the two Samoans going to reunite? And I say, just as soon as Australia and New Zealand unite. Just as soon as Canada and the United States unite. The truth of the matter is, any politician who runs for office in American Samoa and were to advocate independence will lose badly at the polls. We actually like our relationship with the United States, and we're very proud of that relationship.